Okay, welcome back to MBR. And I'm going to explain to you how to manifest. I've two full pages right here on it. I've just done it there now for this here. But the only thing is, I don't think I'm going to give it, or I'm not going to give it to you. I'm going to explain it to you. Why? Because I was writing it out like, I was looking to manifest all this, and I think I'm going to make it my goal to do this myself. So what you can do is, I'm going to give you a few tips out of it, and there's going to be four main things that you need to do or focus on. So if you get a piece of paper and pen and write it down, because if you're just going to watch the video, you won't do it afterwards. You will say, I'll do it this, then, whatever. But you won't actually put it into practice and do it. So here goes. You want to write down your personal life. Your financial life. Business life. And spiritual life. So, personal life. You want to talk about all, you want to imagine the life that you wish for. So if this life is to be living in a different country, to have your own business, to be married, happy, have a certain car, have certain people around you, whatever that is, you need to actually write it down so you know what your goal is. When you write it down, I want you to read over it 3 to 5 times a day and to keep repeating this. Best times is in the morning time and at night time. When you're at night time, going into your subconscious mind, getting closer into the delta waves, I think it's delta waves. And then when you're waking up, you're coming out of them. So your subconscious mind is more aware of how you're feeling about that, what your true sense of purpose is. So in return, it feeds it back to you. So you just explain your personal life in that sense. And the same with the financial, this spiritual, financial, for example. So if you wanted to be a millionaire, would it be, did you want to, how would you be as a millionaire? Now, I want you to think this out carefully, because doing this could backfire on you if you don't do it right. So if you're going to be a millionaire, now you don't want to go broke. So what I'm saying is, if you're a millionaire and you have a house that's worth a million, and then you don't have any other money to cover them costs to keep that house, well, you're going to go broke. So you've got to think it out carefully. What exactly is it that you want? Business, the same as. What do you want? Do you want customers coming regularly? Is it just a business that you want? It's easy to have a business. You can say you have a business, but yet no customers. How many customers do you want to have each week, each month, each year? How much do you want to be making each of these customers? You want to describe it on paper. And then your spiritual life. Is it an awakening you're looking for? Is it to be connected to that higher senses so you can see things better, so you can let the rest of these other things at ease because you know how to work it? Is it to have an understanding of others or an understanding of the universe, or what is it exactly you want out of it, your spiritual life? When I say spiritual, I don't mean, it doesn't even have to be into higher consciousness or whatever. Your spiritual life can be, because everything is actually spiritual when you really think about it. Spiritual life is how do you want to connect with everything? In what sense to yourself? How are you going to be as a person? How do you want to see yourself with others, to react with others, to intervene with other people? Do you want to be in connection with other people, or do you want to be away from that? What exactly is it that you want? Now, once you put all this on paper like this, as I say, 3 to 5 times a day. Main times is night time and morning time, because these are the two most important times where you're coming into that subconscious mind. Also, if you do meditate, because, and this is just something, because not everybody meditates, and not everybody wants to meditate, and people find it hard, and I give you ways to try and make it easier, but people are still not gonna do it because they have their own set beliefs, and that's all right, because it's not easy for everyone to change. It wasn't easy for me to change my ways, and I've still a lot of ways to change, don't get me wrong, but there's still beliefs, limited beliefs that we have that we do want to change, and like myself, and that's why I think that I will go with this myself. So put it into practice. You don't have to meditate, but if you do meditate, it would be a time to use it. Before and after the meditation, I would recommend. Before, because it's the intention. After, because you're just coming out of that state, that focused state, and you're able to focus on what you've wrote, so you'd be able to put more feelings and emotions into it. And when you can put the feeling and emotion into it, well, it'll feel like you've already got that life. And when you feel that you've already got that life, well, then all the universe can do is send you back the same way you feel, or send you back the same vibrational field in that line of the way that you feel. For example, do you ever notice if you running late for work, for example, and instead of phoning work to let work know that you're gonna be late, you ignore the phone? And now you know deep down, if you phone work, for example, right, you're going out of the house, you realize you have a flat wheel in the car. So you panic and you start rushing to get that wheel fixed instead of picking up the phone and phoning work. And you know deep down that work's going to have an understanding that, well, you've got a flat wheel, there's nothing you can do about it, they're going to have to wait. So that's just the way life is. And if so, maybe you have to work that wee bit longer or something. But there's no stress when you're able to take your time, do it, you've let them know. But if you don't, you start freaking out and trying to get that wheel changed, and then you're swearing, cursing, and giving out, and before you know it, you slip or something and you bang your hand, and then it's just making it worse, everything's getting more heightened. by the time you get the wheel changed, you're in that mood where you're just, everything, the impacts externally is negative. So you're hitting the lights and every light just seems to be red. People are pulling out in front of you and it's causing you to swear and course at them. You go to park in your usual parking spot and someone else is pulled into it. So you try to park into another spot, but that spot's just a wee bit tight, but you try it anyway. And then you end up scratching the side of your car and someone else's. Then you get into work and your boss is giving out to you for not letting them know and saying, why didn't you phone? Do you see how it works? This is the attraction that you brought upon yourself through your anger, through your frustration. I hope you understand how that vibration works in return. This is Mind Body Reprogramming. Hopefully you can make these steps to go forward in your life. Remember, do it 3 to 5 times a day, definitely before bed and when you're waking up. Your personal life, your financial life, business and spiritual life. Hopefully this can help you move forward to the life that you wish for. Thank you for listening.